Then we go to the rheumatic diseases. Okay, here the major problem is the pain. Pain can be very disturbing in sexuality. For many people, if you have pain, your desire has gone. Not for everybody, few of them, they do it the other way around. It intends to impair activity and function and possibilities, etc., etc. And it can impair all three levels, desire, arousal, and orgasm. When you have pain, you get also much tension in your muscles, and the pain from one place in a joint can make so much tension that you get pain all in your body, and high tension of your muscles again is not very good for relaxed sex. And then besides that, we can get also a little bit effect of medication, and especially if we use the high dose opioids, then you get a reduction in gonadal hormones and your testosterone goes down, both again in the man and in the women, with the consequences on sexual desire again. Now, pain is a sex killer. But on the other way, you could say sex could be a painkiller. And that's what gradually we hear that a little bit more. It's even very recently, it was again, they had research on, how do you call it, that kind of headache, migraine headache. Even in migraine headache, 50% of the people with migraine headache get less pain when they have sex and when they have an orgasm. And that's funny because headache is used as a joke, but by many people, not to have sex. In my rehab center, I'm working in a rehab center where we have a lot of chronic pain. And we try to teach the patients that you could turn it the other way around. And the way it works is that on the one hand, everything which is distracting will give less pain. So if you have a good soccer match, or you have a complex Sudoku, or a romantic movie, or good sex, you will have less pain. But there is something additional in women. In women, in the frontal side, on the frontal side of your vagina, you have receptors. And if you stimulate those receptors, you give a message to your brain, and you make endorphins. And the endorphins can increase your pain threshold by up to 100%. Now this is what happens. What happens, and that is evolutionary, is very clearly to explain through the delivery process. But the same you can use proactively in patients, and that's what we do. We tell the patients with chronic pain, why not, instead of saying, I have pain, I don't want sex, I have pain, I want sex. Then of course, don't phone your husband who has to come to drive 1 hour and then give a lot of foreplay. Then you have to separate function from romance, from relationship, and use a good vibrator, and use the vibrator if possible inside the vagina, close to the G-spot. That is where those receptors are. And that is, old-fashioned women knew that, and they told it their daughters when they had menstruation pain. Nowadays, even gynecologists frequently don't know this, which is a pity. Now, when you have sex, it's also the muscular relaxation, it's also the increase in oxytocin, and what, as I explained, the genital stimulation. Now, dealing with pain in sex, what is important is how is a couple doing it? Because you have some husbands, especially if the woman has pain, the husband who says, no, I deserve sex, I have the right to have sex, then for sure sex will go down with high speed. The other way, the husband who is very careful is also not good, because if he's so careful, nothing will happen. And if nothing will happen, they will have no intimacy and she will feel very guilty. So it's, and man, we are not so very sensitive, so how to know what to do? It's not easy for us. What is important for women, tell what you want to your male partners, to your husbands, and for men, ask what they want, because this is a very difficult thing in many relationships with pain. What we can tell them is give them advice about positions, which is, of course, for many years we didn't want to talk about positions in sexology, because when I started in sexology, we had the idea that if you can have sex in 10 different positions, you won't have a sexual problem. But that's, of course, long ago. So we didn't talk about positions. But in diseases, in rheumatic diseases, in spinal cord injury, and all that things, that kind of things which you see in the rehab center, positions is very important. So we can give them advice. And what I regularly do with pieces of paper, I make with pieces of paper two patients and show them the best position, which is the scissor position, where you have both your legs wide and do like that, which is the best position. But that's difficult to explain here without paper. I'll do that later on.